Feeling good, like I should. Went in the blue walk around the neighborhood. Feeling blessed, never stressed. Got that sunshine on my Sunday best. Yeah. Hey, every day can be a better day despite the challenge. All you gotta do is leave it better than you found it. It's gonna get difficult to stand, but hold your balance. I just say whatever, cause there is no way you're round it. Cause everyone falls down sometimes.
Hello, McGivney, and welcome to our show, Magic Lives On. I'm extremely excited and so proud to share this event, this moment, with all of you. It is a time of reflection and celebration of the magic of McGivney. I want to welcome all of you into my home, and in return, I want to thank all of you for welcoming us into yours. I know I am not alone in saying this, but we all miss McGivney. We miss seeing our friends, our classmates. We miss seeing the teachers, the custodial and secretarial staff. We miss the physical building, our classrooms, the gymnasium, the cafeteria, the hallways, the library, and especially the co-op office. McGivney is our home. The amazing thing about all of this is that we don't need a physical space to make us feel like we're there. All of us contribute to that feeling of home. They say, home is where the heart is, while at McGivney, magic is what makes you believe it. Over the next 45 minutes, you will have messages and performances from friendly and familiar faces. You will see different clubs, councils, committees all together to celebrate you. We would like to kick off the show with a heartwarming message from our administration team, Ms. Achusi, Ms. Annabali, and Ms. Gomez.
Hello, McGivney. This is your admin team, Mr. Chutzi, Ms. Annabali, and Ms. Gomes. As we spend more time apart from each other, we all hope that you and your families are keeping well during these extraordinary times.
Today's video theme is Magic Lives On. Have faith in the magic of McGivney. And we know that the community of Father Michael McGivney has always used our faith to guide us in all that we do. We are a community of believers, and it is in grounding of our faith that we find our common strength as one. We are the Magic Nation.
In these times where we can also feel so isolated and alone, we hope that you always remember that you have the family of FMM walking right beside you. As the poem Footprints talks about, we are never alone, and we have our God and our neighbor with us during our toughest times.
As we round out this week, where we celebrated both the value of Catholic education and Teacher Appreciation Week, we are constantly reminded about the hope that is brought to us by those who we encounter each and every day.
Remember to share that light that lives within you to brighten the world around you. We think of you and we pray for you every day. We miss you and we hope that we will all be together again soon.
To kick things off, here is our favorite music teacher performing a special song for us all. Take it away, Mr. Mungada.
Have you ever felt forgotten in the middle of nowhere? Have you ever felt like you could disappear? Like you could fall, no one would hear. Let that lonely feeling wash away. Maybe there's a reason to believe you'll be okay. When you don't feel strong enough to stand, you can reach out your hand. And oh, dark comes crashing through. When you need a friend to carry you, when you're broken on the ground, you will be found. Let the sun come streaming in, as you'll reach up and you'll rise again. Lift your head and look around, you will be found. You will be found. You will be found. You will be found. You will be found.
Hey, feeling good. Thank you, Mr. Moncada and the Musical Council, for yet again another beautiful performance. Mr. Moncada and the Musical Council have done so many wonderful things, gracing our school with your musical talents. Thank you again. Continuing on with performances, we have Holy Ann performing The Climb by Miley Cyrus.
Stay strong, McGivney. I can almost see it, that dream I'm dreaming, but there's a voice inside my head saying, you'll never reach it. Every step I'm taking, every move I make feels lost with no direction. My faith is shaking, but I gotta keep trying, gotta keep my head held high. There's always gonna be another mountain, I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle, but so sometimes I'm gonna have to lose. Ain't about how fast I get there, ain't about what's waiting on the other side. It's a climb.
Hey McGivney, I just wanted to take this minute to say that I hope you're all doing well. I miss you so much. I miss my students and our teams and our clubs, and I hope we get to see each other very soon. During this time, I've been trying to keep myself busy by testing my artistic abilities. Some would say I'm the next Michelangelo. So I've been writing positive messages and drawing on my friends' driveways and on the sidewalks, and I did one for you. Don't forget, McGivney, the magic lives on.
Hey McGivney, hope you're all staying home and staying safe. Words cannot describe how much I miss Magic Nation right now. But with your support, your thoughts, and your prayers, we will get through this and come out of it together as a stronger community. One way I like to get away from all the craziness and stress is to hang out with our rabbits. Remember, the magic lives on.
Hey McGivney, we miss your beautiful faces. Tips for staying home, cook meals with your family, and eat with them. Sleep 8 hours, preferably at night. Go for walks, and remember, to strengthen the muscles of your heart, the best exercise is lifting someone else's spirit whenever you can. Magic lives on.
Now, a special message from Ms. Selva Kumar.
Thanks, Ethan. One thing is so obvious. The magic of McGivney was never about our physical building. It's about our community and our relationships with each other. It's about what we value and what we love. It's about the faith that we share and the ways in which we live that out. I know that you join me in thanking Mathushin, Mr. Ambita, and all the students who put this magical night together. Grade 9s, 10s, and 11s, we're thankful that we can continue to journey with you and make more magical memories together. Grade 12s, the only thing that disappoints me about this year is the fact that we don't have the chance to spend this final year with you. You guys are so lovable, so talented, and so enthusiastic. Even now, you're all stepping up in such beautiful ways to show your leadership. Wherever you go, I know you'll be magical. And one day we will get to celebrate with you again. We realize in this time that we don't have as much power or as many choices as we thought we did. But especially in this moment, we realize that we do have the power to control how we respond and react to things. So respond well, McGivney, as you always have. Keep loving and serving others in whatever ways God calls you to do that. Emerge from this period of time an even stronger, better, and more beautiful version of yourselves. Emerge from this time like a butterfly out of a cocoon, not like a zombie emerging from a tomb. It'll take some effort, some discipline, and maybe a haircut, but we can do this. God bless you, McGivney. You're in my prayers.
Thank you, Ms. Selva Kumar, for sharing those beautiful words with us. Up next, another performance from Johanna Alilio, singing an original song, Until We Grow Old.
McGivney, I know it's really easy to focus only on the negatives with all that's going on, but I think we need to try and find positives. And I think there is one that we should be focusing on, and that is we have been given time that we otherwise wouldn't have had. And I'm challenging all of McGivney to use that for two things. One, use it to improve upon something you've always wanted to improve upon. Whether you want to get better at a musical instrument, or painting, or writing, or sports skills, if it's safe to do so. Use it to improve upon something you've always wanted to improve upon. And two, use it to try or learn something totally new. Whether it's learn a new instrument, learn a new language. It doesn't have to be French, even though Mr. Carozza probably tells you French is the best language to learn. Doesn't have to be French. You can even read a book from beginning to end in that order. Not because Mr. Dicaria is forcing you to do so for his English class. I myself am going to use this time to try and learn a new instrument. And even though Mr. Moncada, I can hear him begging me not to do this, for the sake of all eardrums, I'm going to try and learn the violin. Remember, McGivney, you are not alone. You are surrounded by people who care about you, your friends, your family, and even your teachers. I miss you all. I cannot wait to get back to school so I can see you guys in person and walk into class and hear for the first time in a very long time, Sir, can we move the test? Stay safe, McGivney. Magic lives on.
You are all doing well and keeping your spirits up. So, true story, I have four kids and our TV just died. And as difficult a time as this is, think about it this way. If you're missing your friends, well, at least you have friends who miss you too. If your family is getting on your nerves because they're stressed and anxious at this time too, well, at least you have a family to be with during this time. And if you're tired of all of this online learning, at least you have the mental and physical ability to learn new things. And if you're feeling anxious and overwhelmed and frustrated, well, at least you have the biggest support system in our McGivney family. And at least we are just one I am away. Believe and trust that our blessings will always be bigger than any trouble. Well, at least we will be together again. Because the
magic lives on!
Hi, McGivney. Ms. Dereka here. I hope everyone's well and finding healthy ways to keep busy during these unprecedented times. I don't know about you, but my list of hobbies increased significantly in the last 7 weeks. I've been doing puzzles, creating photo books, games, and yes, sadly, even the odd TikTok. They have since been deleted for everyone's benefit. I just wanted to say that I look forward to going back to school and seeing everyone. To my SG family, I look forward to that first event that we can plan together again. And to all of McGivney, remember, while we may be physically separated, we are always united. The magic lives on.
Hey McGivney, it's Miss Hunt. Just wanted to say hello and let you know how much I missed you all over the last couple of weeks. You know, it's been really hard not to see your smiling faces in class every day, but I do hope that each and every one of you and your families are all safe and happy during this time. One of the things that my family's been doing has been to share recipes. So we've been trading different cooking and baking ideas, some which have been better than others, but we've really kind of made an effort to make each other a priority and to celebrate meal times together. So I do hope you know that your McGivney family is always thinking about you, and remember, the magic lives on.
Oh, hi McGivney. Wishing you a wonderful time, a wonderful spring days and sunlight. Enjoy yourself, walk, do exercise. We soon will come back together. And magic lives on. Bye-bye.
Hey, McGivney. Just wanted to take a moment to say that the staff at Father Michael McGivney misses you all so very much, and we're hoping that you and your families are keeping safe and well. We can't wait to work with you again. We miss your smiling faces and your energy. It's not the same being at home without all of you. One tip to stay healthy and well during this time, doesn't take much, but just enjoy the simple pleasures, like music. Just remember, during these difficult times, that you need to keep your head up. We love you guys and miss you. Magic lives on.
Thanks, Joanna. Your voice is majestic. Up next, we have a video from the Student Athletic Council to give all of you tips on how to keep mentally and physically healthy.
Thanks, Mr. Obita. And hey there, Magic Nation. Today, I'm going to be showing you a few simple ways to stay active at home with the help of my friends on the Student Athletic Council. We got James, we got John, we got Mothi, and we got Kristen over there in the back. We also have a few special guests later on in the video. Let's get started.
Hey, Magic Nation. Staff knows that this may be a crazy time for many of you. We also know that many of you may not be motivated to stay active. But come on, get out that couch and let's get that blood pumping. First, we're going to start with a stretch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 10 jumping jacks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And then we're gonna do 10 second high knees and then 10 second butt kicks. 7, 8, 9, 10. Right, from there we're gonna go into butt kicks.
Time for butt kicks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Wow, I'm really feeling the sweat.
Great job, guys.
So, next exercise we're gonna do is we're gonna do squats. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna place our feet shoulder width apart, and then we're just gonna go down, and we want to make sure that our knees are going over our toes. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, thank you, McGivney. Make sure you guys follow us on FMM SAC to get more.
I'm out of breath.
Now they're all warmed up. Let's get going.
Don't forget to stay hydrated.
Wow, I'm feeling the burn, McGivney. But we know working out can require a lot of commitment. So here are some other alternatives that you can do at home to stay active by former SACers at FMM.
This
is
how
we are
staying
active
during quarantine.
One,
two,
three,
four, five,
six,
seven,
eight,
nine, ten.
Wow, that was great. Thanks, McGivney, for joining us. And follow at FMMSAC for more content. Thanks, everyone. And stay safe.
Hello, McGivney. Welcome to the Wu household. We hope you're all staying healthy, safe, and doing your part to flatten the curve.
Like you, we've been stuck in quarantine for the last 7 weeks, and one of the number one questions we've been getting is, how do you manage to survive in quarantine with one-year-old twins?
I mean, to be honest with you, we really haven't noticed a difference.
I mean, I've been using this time to hone in on my cooking skills.
Burger. Is this avocado and bacon? Awesome. Best one yet.
Love it.
I've been using this time to learn a new musical instrument.
That sounded great.
Thanks.
I've been doing some reading. I average about 3 books a day. So we have The Very Hungry Caterpillar.
Ooh, classic.
Some of my favorites right here. Goodnight Moon.
Nice. Like this one too.
Where the Wild Things Are.
Ooh, scary.
And my ultimate favorite is Love You Forever.
Wow, this one's a good read. Like some of you, we've also been trying our hands at puzzles, and we're currently working on this real difficult one.
It's hard.
It is.
I think though, this one goes right here, and
oh, that's right.
I think this one goes here.
Yes, another puzzle done.
Awesome.
Teamwork. And when we're not playing musical instruments, reading books, or working on a tough puzzle, we've been connecting with you through distance learning. And we've obviously needed our trusty laptop in order to do that.
Tap, tap, click, click, typing away.
So you can see, we really haven't really noticed a difference.
Yeah, no, not at all.
In all seriousness, we know the days have been long.
And we know that you're bored.
But keep in mind, we're all in this together.
You're not alone.
There is a light at the end of the tunnel.
And we will come out a stronger McGivney community.
So please, McGivney, stay safe, stay healthy, try spending some quality time with your family.
And remember,
the magic lives on.
Hey, feeling good.
Mr. Dormar sits down with our librarian, Ms. McCarthy, to talk about what it's like working at the hospital.
Good morning, Ms. McCarthy. How are you today?
Good, thank you. How are you?
Good, good. Excellent.
I take it you ran out of razors.
Look at this. It's growing over my ear. And you know how long it took me to get my hair like this morning? I have like, when I wake up, it's like everywhere. And I was like, oh man, should I wear a hat for the interview? But then, you know, Muthushan is probably going to yell at me for wearing a baseball hat. A lot of our students at McGivney know you as our school librarian, but not a lot of students at McGivney also know that you are a registered nurse working in the hospitals. So can you tell us, all the McGivney family, what got you into the healthcare field?
Actually, I started off as a registered nurse. And at the time I went into nursing, I loved maths and sciences. So it just seemed the natural place to go. And funnily enough, a good friend of mine went into teaching and I thought, oh my God, why would anybody ever want to be a teacher? So it was the maths and science. I loved them. And if I could take more of them and work in the area, that's what led to me going into nursing. I had done a lot of jobs in nursing. I started off in orthopedics. I went to spinal orthopedics. I did Toronto General Emerge till 2000. I'd done educator roles, home care. But the job I had was administration and the hours were really long and I had young kids and I thought I needed change.
So Ms. McCarthy, given the fact that we're going through this time, this pandemic, and you are going in to work on a part-time basis at the hospital, what's the current mood like in the hospital for the people working there, like all the frontline health workers?
It's very interesting. The one thing I say to people is, you know what, at least we know what it is. In healthcare, we've been through a lot, and if we have been around for a while, you know that. When I first started nursing, we had the HIV outbreak, and people don't remember. We used to do, you know, gown, mask, glove, hat, everything we could, because we didn't know how it was spread. We didn't realize at that time it was, you know, body fluids. So every patient that came in with HIV, it was much like COVID. We would mask and gown and the whole hazmat going in and trying to do things like that. We've been through SARS, we've been through MERS, we've been through H1N1. There was the Ebola threat. So it, on the upside, we know what it is. And when we know what it is, at least we can prepare and handle it. The challenge for us is the same as it is for you. We're frustrated because we keep hearing mixed messages, and that's really frustrating. Some people will say, oh, you're okay with just the mask. Other people say, no, you need the N95s, you know, cover your eyes, you know, wear a full shield, don't let any skin come out. So the mixed messages are really frustrating for us because we are trying to take care of our patients and also not bring it home. And a lot of the healthcare workers are isolating themselves from their family if they have young children or older parents because they aren't risking a spread.
So with all the media and the news releases, a lot of times the message is very negative, let's just say. A lot of challenges, a lot of unknowns, like you're saying. But are there any aspects being at work in the hospital where there's a little bit of positivity at the hospital? Like, is there something that the workers are looking at and saying, you know what, we're going to get through this. There are positive things that are happening right now. Is there anything that's happening at the hospital that gives everybody a hope that this is eventually going to end?
Yes, and there's a lot of positives. We were kind of laughing, you know what, our pediatric admission numbers are way down because we've discovered that when kids stay away from each other, they don't get sick. We've also learned the area I work in now is labor and delivery, and we're discharging patients within 4 to 6 hours, and the patients are really happy about it. We've set a system into motion where somebody comes in to see them in their house. They don't have to leave their house. Our length of stays are down. Our patients are happier. We're happier to see them go home early. So there's a lot of really positive things that we are learning through it. Emerge numbers are down. People are realizing that they're not going to go in unless it's something really serious. I think as a staff, you sort of develop the same mindset as people at McGivney, and the magic is all about is we're in this together, and together we can do this. It's not the best situation. It's not what we would pick, but we're doing it, and it's going to eventually get better.
Knowing that a lot of our students are at home, are isolated, what do we continue? What would you tell our McGivney family to continue to do to help get us out of the situation, knowing the fact that the weather is going to get better, warmer, which makes now that urge to go outside and potentially contract the virus?
I guess the biggest message is to follow the guidelines. Social distance, wash your hands. Hopefully you've been doing this your whole life. Wash your hands. Before you eat, if you go in your house, wash your hands. If you go outside of your house and come back in, wash your hands. And just being protective, but hang in there. It really is tough. We've done so well for 7 weeks. It's just a little bit longer. And in the meanwhile, if you go out, please social distance. Please wash your hands. You can enjoy the fresh air. Unfortunately, it has to be at a distance for now. And I think our world will change for a little while. There's a lot of mass gatherings we won't have. But on the upside is people you love won't be getting sick. And we know it hits elderly, but there are also some really young people in their 40s, 50s, and 30s who've gotten very, very sick. So I think I would reflect on the positive. You have done a great job so far. Just hang in there. We're now heading towards the end. The end is almost there. The world won't be the same. It might even be better. And hopefully we've had an opportunity to learn a bit about our families, enjoy a little bit of family time, even as we figure out our space. So just hang in.
Sing to me the song of the stars, of your galaxy dancing and laughing again. When it feels like my dreams are so far, sing to me of the plans you have for me over again. So I lay my head back down and I lift my hands and pray to be only yours. I pray to be only yours. I know now you're my own. Giving you all of me, I want your symphony singing in all that I am. At the top of my lungs, I'm giving it back. So I lay my head back down and I lift my hands and pray to be only yours. I pray to be only yours. I pray to be only yours. I know now you're my only
next, we have a dance performance by our own McGivney's dance crew. Hired a butler and got me a waiter. I wanna get married, but none of my shorties remind me of Jada. Maybe I'm just too afraid to settle. I wish I was planning it different. I think it's a phase.
Hey McGivney, long time no see from the dance crew. We hope that you and your family are doing well in this quarantine. We know how tough times can be right now, but we can all take our part in this pandemic by staying at home.
When you do go outside, make sure to take all the necessary precautions. This means washing your hands regularly and avoid touching your face. On behalf of Dance Crew, we wish we could perform live. Therefore,
with the help of the Magic Lives On event, we were able to give you guys a virtual dance performance. Even though Dance Crew can't practice together physically, that still doesn't stop us from dancing together as one. So, without further ado, we hope you enjoyed this dance performance, and here is FMM's Dance Crew. I think I made a mess. I'm in Cali with a vest. That's the Wild Wild West. I told my homies I'm good with the labels, I don't need to sign the dots. They must not know me, they cannot control me, cause I ain't no iRobot. Yeah, I grew up on a legend and I gotta show it. I learned a lot from him and I owe it. Homie's my idol and don't even know it. Ooh. I'm feeling like Will, I feel like a prince, I'm feeling myself. I'm loaded with bills, cause I wasn't blessed with no Uncle Phil. Don't know how it feels, I wanted to flex, they told me to chill. I'm making a flip, my life is a flick, now load up the film. I'm going back to Miami to meet with the cartel. All of you rappers be running around telling shark tales. Hey,
time to give me students. Well, you can't take me out, and I can't let you out. Just wanted to let you know that we're missing you, and hopefully you miss us just a little bit, even though you get to spend time online. You're making history. It's really important that you know that. You have kept us all very safe, and we appreciate it. Hopefully we'll get back together before the end of the school year and do our goodbyes. If not, it'll be hello in the fall. And the grade 12s, I expect you to come back and say hello and goodbye at the same time. It's really important that we're all in this together. And together, the magic lives on.
Pastel pink in the sunset. You know I never want to make you upset. How did I become so obsessed?
Hey guys, today's video is sponsored by SeatGeek. SeatGeek is an app where you can find tickets in the easiest way possible.
You've seen them help me surprise my friends with brand new cards. So today, SeatGeek is going to help me surprise Karshana with a brand new car.
Oh my god, David, what is that? No way.
It's a new car.
Thank you so much, a Honda Civic. Oh my god.
Welcome back to SpeedTill. Today, we have some interesting news about popular YouTubers Renee and Eric. This whole situation started when Eric tweeted out some very shocking news. He said, "Who takes 3 minutes to microwave their food?" He later released a video exposing the fact that this person was Renee Edward.
The thing she did was, she microwaved her lasagna for 3 whole minutes.
After this video, Renee tweeted out an apology, but fans were not satisfied, and now trending on Twitter is hashtag RenaeIsOverParty. Renee later posted an apology video for her actions.
I am truly sorry for everyone who has heard about the situation going on.
She then tries to defend herself.
But in my defense, the lasagna that I had for lunch that day did not heat properly.
Later, Eric responded to fans' questions in a video.
A lot of you guys have been asking if I forgive Renee, and the answer is no. I don't think you understand, or she understands, how much trouble she put me through.
Both of them seem to be dealing with a lot right now. But whose side are you on?
Alright, so we just saw part of one of the greatest videos that I've ever seen. How to shoot a basketball properly from the one and only, our grade 9 rep, Garen, but his younger version. So we're going to continue. Let's see where this goes.
90!
Oh. Pause. Grandma knows how to play basketball? I'm impressed. Ooh, swinging the dab there as well.
I can see my grandma in the background.
Spread apart.
Man, I'm doing a basketball instruction video. One of the first things should be I should wear athletic wear, and I'm wearing jeans and a plaid shirt. Hey, I got it in.
Welcome to Watch SoGo, and today we're counting down our top 7 picks for high school essentials. Coming in at number 7, we have the gum pack. Almost every day you'll be asked if you have a piece of gum. If you go into high school with the whole pack, students will come running after you. Coming in at number 6 is colored pens. What's a better way to make our notes colorful and pretty? When students forget to bring a pen, you will be their go-to. At number 5, we have a proper fit. Everyone practically looks the same in uniform, but when it's civvies day, a proper fit will distinguish you. At number 4, we have the one and only AirPods. What more do you want than to block all the haters and look cool while you're walking up the stairs? Coming in at number 3 is the phone charger. What is worse when your phone is at 20% when you get to school? You will never leave high school without ever being asked 100 times if you had a phone charger. You will be the plug of the school. At number two, we have the Toonie. $1.50 for a calf cookie? I got you. $2 for bus fare? I got you. A Toonie will be the essential for a lifetime of friends. And coming in at the number one spot is a passionate love for Jeopardy music. You will hear this song every single day for 4 years of your life, so you better learn to love it. So which of these high school essentials is your favorite? Let us know in the comments below and subscribe to our channel at Watch Sogo. This is Karshana, and I'll see you next time.
You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. You'd be like heaven in touch. I wanna hold you so much. At long last, love has arrived, and I thank God I'm alive. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. But in the way that I stare, there's nothing else to compare. The sight of you leaves me awake. There are no words left to speak. But if you feel like I feel, please let me know. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you.
Hey McGivney, hope you're all healthy and safe. Don't forget to exercise. Oh, hey, so try a few squats, try a few push-ups, get nice and strong, and hopefully I'll see you soon. The magic lives on.
Hey, McGivney, it's Miss Sum. I miss you, your smiles, and your good mornings. Well, let's do some exercises to keep you healthy. Math aerobics, positive slope, negative slope. Don't forget your parabolas, your happy faces, vertical stretches, compressions, and you can move two to the left and two to the right.
I hope that puts a smile on your face. May God bless you. Magic lives on, McGivney.
What's up, McGivney? How's it going? Hope everybody's doing okay and staying safe. Just gonna give you a couple of tips of what we do here in the Dharma household to keep busy. Do a lot of sports and a lot of activities. So for example, take a look. And the last one for you guys, right here, on tape. What's up, McGivney? How's everybody doing? Hope everybody's doing well during this tough time. Just want to tell you guys, we're thinking about you guys. We miss you guys. Missing you guys in the hallways, in the gym, in class, obviously. Missing those bubble tea runs. But I'm sure we'll get through this, and we will see each other soon. There's a car there. Magic lives on.
SMM community. Mrs. Johnson from the Learning Library Commons to say hello to everyone and to wish you good health in this time. I'm missing the lineups of all your faces for the staff and the students collecting Chromebooks and telling you when they're due and collecting my signs. I have my friend Murphy here, our family dog, who's keeping me company these days. I'm missing everyone and I'm looking forward to when we can return. Magic lives on.
Give me. Hope you guys are all keeping well and safe. Just wanted to say I miss seeing your friendly faces coming into the main office. Remember, stay positive by being thankful for all the things in your life that make you happy. Remember, magic lives on. Hope to see you guys soon.
As SLAM leaders and former students of McGivney, we know the importance of leadership and how to be a great influence to others.
During times like these, where happiness just doesn't seem near, we must be positive role models for our brothers and our sisters and remind them that we are all in this together.
It is easy to lose faith during times like these when everything appears to be falling, but we need to remember to look towards God for guidance and help each other through these challenging situations.
At times, it's easy to get caught up in our personal struggles. And while these are valid and heard, it's also important to be there for others.
Check in on the grade 9s who may be nervous and disappointed that the first year of high school wasn't all that they'd hoped it would be. Pray for the grade 12s who are missing out on important events and experiences as high school comes to an end.
Tell your family you love them and spend time with your brothers and sisters. But most importantly, thank God for anything and everything.
Health, love, food, freedom, education, or just another day on earth. Whatever you do, be someone who spreads hope, because that's what leaders do.
Hey, McGivney.
Hey, McGivney.
Hey, McGivney.
Hey, McGivney. Thank you so much for tuning in.
Make sure to use the hashtag MagicLivesOn to let us know you're watching.
And follow FMMSAC, SG, Music Council, SLAM, and Dance Crew on Instagram.
Special thanks to Mr. Ambita and Mathushin for making this event possible, as well as all of our performers and staff for taking part.
Now back to the show.
It's okay. Hey, feeling good. Like I should.
Thank you to the student leaders at McGivney for that wonderful video message. Coming up next, we have Sue, who will be putting on a dance performance for all of you.
days. Some days you wake up and nothing works, you feel surrounded.
Thank you, Soup, for dazzling us with those intricate dance moves. Amazing. Speaking of amazing, the next performer may be small in size, but she's definitely mighty and strong with her voice. We have Sarah May performing an original song.
Routine while at home will make you motivated and healthy. That's why I wake up early, exercise, and as many of you know, consult my cat trivia calendar. Let's see what our furry friends have to say today. According to studies, a cat in the house is the emotional equivalent of having a romantic partner. Don't have a cat. Wait a second. Plato and Aristotle are feline philosophical friends. What more do you need? Remember, whether you're at home, at school, or on your way to graduation, the magic lives on.
We now return to your regular programming.
Hey, McGivney. I'm here with a message of positivity for you. I know the situation sucks, but it could be worse. Imagine you were stuck in quarantine with Carosa, and you had to listen to him talk about his dog every second of every day. Stay positive, because this too shall pass, and the magic lives on. Imagine you were stuck in quarantine with Carosa, and you had to listen to him talk about his dog every second of every day.
McGivney, Mr. Carosa, and Mrs. Otis. I'm thinking of all of you. I miss all of you. I miss the building. I can't wait until we're back there creating memories again. Throughout the times of the pandemic, something I'm doing to eat up some time is learn a new skill and also pick up an old hobby that I've had to leave behind. And I hope you find time to do the same. I can't wait to be back in the halls of McGivney creating magic, because the magic lives on.
The Wizard of Oz, a classic film, an oldie but a goodie, one of my favorite films growing up as a kid. Performing Somewhere Over the Rainbow is Jemele Marfil. This is the only musical talent I have.
playing the drums, virtually, in Animal Crossing. Someone who's actually talented in real life is Alyssa Ardit. She'll be playing her drums to the song Love Never Felt So Good by Michael Jackson. So there you have it. We have come to the conclusion of our event, Magic Lives On. There are many people who made this possible. Thank you to all the staff who shared wonderful words of positivity and encouragement. Thank you to the alumni who continue to show love and support for our McGivney community. Thank you to Student Government, SAC, SLAM, Music Council, Dance Crew, and all the performers who graced us with your expertise and your talent. And last but not least, thank you to the person who put all of this together, Methushin. You are an amazing person with a constant vision of togetherness. You are truly an inspiration to everyone. Whether you watch the show from start to finish, skip parts and view it over a period of time, or just fast forward it to the end and this is the first thing you're seeing, we want to thank you. We want to thank you for taking the time to hang out with us. We hope you got up and danced, or perhaps maybe sang along to the performances. We hope you laughed, or maybe even cried. Our ultimate goal was to have you leave with a smile on your face and in your hearts. We want you to know that you're missed and you are loved. We cannot wait to be together again. But until then, continue to hold on to what you cherish the most. Keep dreaming and keep believing. And know that because of you and all the people that made this possible, magic lives on. Thank you.
Hey McGivney, my name is Mathushin and I'd like to thank you all for tuning in to this special event. This event was created to put a smile on your face and lift up your spirits, and I hope we did just that. When I created the Magic Lives On movement, I thought about all the great memories I created at McGivney throughout my 4 years, and I realized that the magic of McGivney will always live on, because the magic starts and ends with you. Stay safe and believe in magic.